Welcome to the Eden Show!
Hey. I didn't see you there. We have a real treat for you guys today. I'm gonna welcome Chad over here. We're gonna have an in-depth conversation today. Chad, would you like to join me? Thank you. Right. You're such a stranger, Chad. Get a little close. So, Chad, what have you been up to lately?
I've been reading.
I have too. What have you been reading?
A special book called Animal Farm. What I just loved about this classic was one of the major characters, his name was Snowball. He was very articulate, he was a catalyst, and he was very influential.
He's just a wonderful static character. I like him. Yeah. I also really like Napoleon. For some reason, his corruptness appealed to me. You know, just how forceful and persuasive he was is really, really intriguing. Yeah.
He was also a very interesting static character.
I completely agree with you. Good insights to this classical novella. Mm-hmm. Talk about the function! Talk about the function! Okay, so, Chad. What would you say the function was for the author including Snowball in this novel?
I think the function of Snowball in this novel was that he helped initiate the rebellion. He became a face of the enemy after he was kicked out, and he was also a scapegoat.
That's awesome. That's really wonderful, deep insight, Chad. Thank you. Thank you, Chad. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
It's been a pleasure. Awesome. Yeah. After this short break, we have another surprise guest for you. Thank you. And we're back. We have a special guest for you. Well, let's welcome Shalia Jones to the stage. Hello. It's nice to meet you, Shalia. Take a seat. It's awesome to finally meet you. Before the break, we were discussing the book Animal Farm.
I love that book.
I'm so glad I do too. It's one of my favorites. Such a classic. So, we were talking about the major characters, Snowball and Napoleon. Mm-hmm. Yes, we talked about the details, the function that Snowball played in the book, but we haven't yet gone into depth about Napoleon's role. So, are you ready to do that with me today?
Absolutely.
Awesome. From your perspective, what would you say is Napoleon's function in Animal Farm?
I think Napoleon's function in Animal Farm is that he tried to distinguish himself from other farm animals and led a group after kicking out Snowball.
I'm just so, so sad, but we're almost out of time, so I'm going to have to catch a break real quick and then dismiss you and bring in our other guests, but really, thank you for coming in.
No problem.
Awesome. Have a great, great night. It's gonna just be a short break, folks, so hang in there.
Animal Farm is a wonderful example of a classic satirical novella using farm animals to shame and expose the Soviet Union's corruption. Orwell uses techniques from irony with the phrase "all animals are equal, but some are more equal than others," to personification when Orwell gives the animals human traits and ideas, such as the act of rebelling, to diction that is easy to understand, especially in that specific time period. He used Squealer as a symbol of propaganda, the windmill as a sign of deception and false hope, and Napoleon's dogs as the secret police of the Soviet Union. Animal Farm by George Orwell. Order it now!
And we're back! Before the break, we were discussing Animal Farm, how absolutely amazing it is, and we're gonna continue that, but first I need to welcome up our special guest. And do I have a treat for you guys! Tonight, I'm gonna choose one person from the audience to join me up here in this discussion. So who wants to come up? You're breathing the same air I am right now, so enjoy this moment. So, have you read the book Annie before?
I've read every single book you've read.
Okay, well then. So the next topic we're going to discuss is... thank you very much, stage boy. Perfect. Okay. What lines really just stood out to you in Animal Farm? What did you just absolutely love about Animal Farm? Specific passages or specific lines? You're like, oh my gosh, that speaks to me so much on like every single level. See, if you want to use the book, you can just use the book.
Well, on page 7,
it says,
man is the only real enemy we have. Remove man from the scene, and the root cause of hunger and overwork is abolished forever. I believe this really set the tone for the beginning of the revolution, and this showed what the animals believed in and strove to abolish Eden.
That's so, so well put. I could not say it better myself. I love that passage. Really, really loved. It's on page 55. It says, bravery is not enough, said Squealer. Loyalty and obedience are more important. I just feel like this passage was a good example of how the pigs manipulated the other animals to do their will, and you know, it expressed perfectly what the pigs expected for the animals to really obey and be loyal to their commands. But yeah, that was this passage I just really liked. Is there anything you wanted to add?
Actually, on the last page, it says, and I quote, "The creatures outside looked from pig to man, and from man to pig, and from pig to man again. But already, it was impossible to say which was which." You know what? I really believe this passage solidifies the drastic change that occurred with the pigs compared to the beginning of the novel. Like, the pigs refuted all of the original commandments of animalism and caused them to become very much like their greatest enemy in the start of the novel, which is, man.
Oh my god. It's just so good. And you know how the saying was on the farm? Yeah? It just added to it. It added to the irony of the entire book, and I'm, oh my god. Composed. What I was trying to say was, I think it's ironic that at the end of the book, the animals become humans, but they're on a farm. And when you think of a farm, you think that's where animals live. And so I just think it's ironic how the animals became what they strove to eradicate in the first place. And just the setting being the farm adds to the irony in the book as a whole, so.
That's true. Well done, Eden.
Thank you. It's in my notes, so it must be true. I ain't come up with it. I don't write these things. So, if it's not true, blame my writer, Melissa. What the? Thank you so much for joining us. But
It's time to go to our next thing.
No, so. No, Eden! I can't leave.
Security! Security! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh, help me! Okay, now that that's over, we're gonna cut to our next segment, which is the exercise segment. Here we go. Okay, we're gonna have fun today. And I'm gonna call up to the stage our wonderful exercise instructor, Chatty. Thank you so much for joining us. We're gonna have fun today. What exercise do you have in store for me to begin with?
Oh, well, I guess you're about to do 200 push-ups right now.
Let's start with 20, okay? All right. So have you, well, you're gonna do it.
I don't have to do it. I'm the instructor.
Okay, have you ever read the book Animal Farm?
Oh, yes, I have.
You have? Okay, would you like to discuss it with you?
Not really, but okay.
Okay.
What do you want to talk about?
Not really. You're a good sport. Mm-hmm. I like that.
Yeah.
I would like to talk about some of the major themes in Animal Farm. If there was anything that stood out to you that you consider to be a major theme?
I think one of the major themes that stuck out to me was that communism, the promise of equality in communism, was a lie. And I got that from the book because Orwell's entire purpose of writing was to put the Soviet Union in a negative view. He tried to degrade the Soviet Union and its... You tired? Are you okay? Yeah, Orwell just tried to degrade the Soviet Union and its ideals of communism. And the main purpose of communism is to promote equality between all its citizens. But as we see in the book, that's not true. Not all the animals were equal. And the pigs definitely lived a high class life, and the rest of the animals definitely suffered for it.
That's wow. It's really deep. I just thought you were all muscle, but look at you. You got more to you than that. Okay, that was... What exercise shall we do next?
Let's try something with the yoga ball.
What would you like me to try with the yoga ball?
How about some stretches?
Okay, I can do that. While I'm doing these stretches, how about you talk about another theme that you like in
another one? I'll have to think hard about that.
Okay, take your time. Do I do sit-ups? Is this good? Is this a good form?
Oh yeah, you're doing fine.
Okay. Anytime now, Chad.
From Animal Farm, I think another theme I found was that propaganda can be so powerful in influencing the decisions of other people.
Yeah.
In the book, you see Squealer, how that pig basically, through his speech and his actions, basically manipulated the whole farm in believing the pigs were right in the decision making and that they should blindly follow the pigs, despite obvious corruption going on within the farm.
Wow, hence the name Squealer. That would make sense. Yeah.
Good observation.
Thank you. Awesome, Jeff.
So I guess overall from the themes that Orwell portrayed in his story, I think that in the end, he wants us people to not believe all the lies that our government tells us. He wants us to think for ourselves and make our own decisions.
Exercise. You know,
it was good, right?
Yeah, was my form? Did you see my form?
Yeah, it was disgusting.
Oh, I was kind of proud for a second there. Towards the end.
Good effort. Alright.
Do I get an A?
D.
That's not failing, so. Thank right. you.
Yeah, thank you.
Have a great afternoon.
See you.
Yeah, okay. That's it for tonight, folks, but don't worry, because tomorrow at 8/7 Central, we'll be back. back on. So I'm gonna
cut.
Oh my gosh! Why do you always interrupt me? Was I done? Did I look done? Melissa? If you do this to me one more freaking time, I swear, Melissa, I will fire you.
So fast, it's over.
Excuse me. I need to go home and take care of my cats. All right? I just bought a new one. Okay, bye.